Blackstone Audio presents Escape Artist, an Edna Ferber mystery by Ed Ifkovic. For my grandkids, Christopher and Emily, with love. Chapter 1. I was getting ready to leave the city room when Sam Ryan mentioned Harry Houdini. Curious, I dawdled at the pinewood table that served as my desk, fiddled with the ancient Oliver typewriter, and shifted some papers.
Last time he was in town, some years back, he performed at the Opera House.
The old man, publisher of the Appleton Crescent, leaned back in his chair. I had no interest in showy carnival antics, too slapdash Circus Maximus for my taste, but Houdini, whose early boyhood had been spent on Appleton streets, always made for good copy. My parents often talked about the escape artist whose father at one time had been rabbi at Zion Congregation.
The great Houdini.
That was Matthias Boone, the new city editor.
The celebrated handcuff king himself.
Miss Ivy, Sam's sister, looked up.
I hear he is staying for a week with David Baum.
Matthias Boone looked surprised.
Who's that?
A childhood friend.
Boone sneered.
You know, I don't understand this malarkey he spouts. Tied up, imprisoned, boasting about escaping. What kind of an act is that?
Byron Beveridge, the beat reporter, broke in, a bit of awe in his voice.
He does this metamorphosis act with his wife. She ties him up and puts him into a box, and in 3 seconds he changes places with her.
Boone grunted.
Impossible. Trickery.
Byron shook his head.
Of course it is. So what?
Barnum was right.
He beamed.
But a real showman.
Foolish, really, such stunts.
Miss Ivy yawned. I kept still, just listened. Sam skimmed the sheets before him.
You know, suddenly he's all the rage in Europe. He can extricate himself from the most complicated set of handcuffs. He's escaped jails in Russian Siberia, in London. He can free himself from a straitjacket.
Miss Ivy spoke over his words.
My brother is a loyal follower.
He can trick innocent souls into forking over hard-earned dollars for some obvious chicanery,
Boone sneered.
Mr. Boone, you're new here in Old Appleton.
You don't understand the appeal of a man like Houdini in this town.
Sam's voice rose, excited.
A real homegrown hero!
Boone frowned.
A grown man strutting around publicly in his BVDs, jumping into nailed boxes, taunting the police.
Byron Beveridge drummed his fingers on his typewriter.
I've seen him perform, in his early days starting out when I worked in Chicago. He was with a dime museum, real shabby, with snake charmers and bearded ladies. Then he reinvented himself. Impressive, I must say.
Boone would have none of it.
Seems to me you small-town folks are easily impressed by circus acts.
He's one of our own. Small-town boy who made it big.
Sam's spectacles slipped down his nose and he readjusted them.
Just proves that the world is nuts, Boone concluded.
He glanced my way but looked through me.
Since he arrived from Milwaukee a few months back, he'd decided that girl reporters shouldn't exist.
Sam pointed to typed pages on his desk.
Houdini's provided us with press sheets, including an interview he gave in London. He expects us to publish them verbatim.
He tapped the sheets with his index finger.
With his curiously ungrammatical quotes.
What are you saying? We can't interview him, we small-town hicks? Boone guffawed. Now the question of the hour is this. How do we get an interview with the man?
Sam grinned.
It seems we don't. He and his brother are here socializing with old buddies, though he's performing a one-shot benefit for the children's home on Platt. The man may crave publicity, but no one's seen him around.
He shrugged.
No interviews, I guess.
The obnoxious little Jew, Boone muttered.
I sat up, iron-backed. There it was. Sam glanced at me while Boone refused to look at me.
Maybe our little Jewess can convince him otherwise.
Maybe this little Jewess will respect...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.